All right, South Carolina, are we happy today? Come on, you're happier than that. We got our vice president here today. Come on, let me hear it. That's wonderful. I'm Pamela Evan, and I'm excited to be here today. I am so excited to be your next lieutenant governor. You know, everybody has asked me, why would you want to do this? Why would you want to enter a life of public service? And I tell them, it's because I am so proud to stand with our governor, Henry McMaster. Come on, guys, I know you saw that debate this week. Didn't he kill it in that debate? You know, our governor showed what true leadership looks like and what good experience looks like. We are so proud to be South Carolinians, aren't we? We want to keep our South Carolina growing. I'm excited to be here today. I'm excited to run as your lieutenant governor. But what we need is we need your help. We need you all out on Tuesday the 26th. Everybody mark their calendars. Everybody getting out to vote. All right. All right. Well, without further ado, we got to keep this program going. I'm going to introduce you to our governor, Henry McMaster. We want to give him 4 more years. Can we say it? 4 more years! 4 more years! 4 more years! Thank you!
Well, I won't back down. No, I won't back down. You can stand me up at the gates of
wonderful. South Carolina, once again, the center of the universe. What a great man we have with us, Mike Pence. He and Donald Trump are the best team that we've ever had. They are magnificent, and they're changing the world right now. I want to remind you, in all this excitement, I know you might forget it's been said, but the big day is Tuesday. We got to remember to vote for Henry on Tuesday. Y'all, South Carolina is winning. As President Trump says, we're winning. We're winning, and we want to keep on winning. Just in the short time I've been in office, I've had the great pleasure of announcing over $6 billion in new capital investment in our state and almost 21,000 new jobs in our state in that short a period. That's the best we've ever done. And we're gonna keep on doing it. You don't change the coach in the middle of a winning season. You give him 4 more years and let him keep on winning, 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 and that's what we're gonna do. And I'll tell you the main reason that we are able to win is great leadership in South Carolina. Whether it's business leaders, preachers, teachers, it doesn't matter. We have great people in South Carolina. And I wanna tell you, when I talk to these companies that come from all over the world looking to spend hundreds of millions or billions of dollars in a place somewhere in America. What they tell me is we're coming to South Carolina. I say, why? They say, we're coming to South Carolina for 3 reasons. The people, and the people. That's why they come to South Carolina. And we're just getting warmed up good. The best is yet to come. But let me introduce a great man to you. One of the greatest conservative leaders in the United States is getting ready to step up on our stage. You've known him as a congressman, you've known him as governor, and now you know him as vice president of the United States. Mike Pence and Donald Trump are a terrific team for the United States of America. We are members of a team that goes from the White House to the State House to your house, and that's why we're winning in South Carolina. Our vice president stands for prayer. He stands for everyone, including our unborn children. He stands up for the taxpayers. He stands up for the Second Amendment. He stands up to the flag, for the flag. And he and Donald Trump are leading America. They're making America great again. And in the process, we are making South Carolina greater than ever. So let's hear it for our vice president, Mike Pence. and his wife, Karen.
She's still in the street, smiling from my head to her feet. I said, hey, what is this? Now, baby, maybe, maybe she's in need of a kiss.
Well, hello, South Carolina. Thank you, Governor, for that great introduction. And I want to ask all of you, right here, right now, at the top, let's give another round of applause to the great leader that South Carolina Republicans are going to say yes to on Tuesday, and we're going to say yes again in November, Governor Henry McMaster. And let me also take a minute before I get started to say thank you to the two incredible, incredible women that stand at both of our sides. I know Henry would want me to give you a chance to give a big round of applause of thanks to the First Lady of South Carolina, Peggy McMaster, and the Second Lady of the United States of America, my wife, Karen Pence. Let's thank them for all they do. Now, before I get started, let me say a word about an extraordinary South Carolina leader who I know is on all of our hearts today. The Republican nominee in the 1st Congressional District, State Representative Katie Arrington. You know, we all learned this morning that Katie and her friend Jackie were in a horrible accident last night on Highway 17, which resulted in one loss of life. We mourn with those who mourn and grieve with those who grieve, and I express our deepest condolences to the family that lost a loved one in this accident. And I know I speak for everyone all across South Carolina and really people all across America when I say that that family and Katie and Jackie are in our prayers. I spoke to Katie's husband, Rob, just a few minutes ago from Air Force Two. He informed me that Katie sustained serious injuries that are going to require additional surgery. So might be in the hospital for the next couple of weeks. But Rob told me that Katie Arrington's spirit is strong. He said how moved he's been by the outpouring of support. Outpouring of support to their family. Even Katie's opponent, Joe Cunningham, I'm told, suspended his campaign in the wake of this accident. That was a classy move that reminds us why South Carolina is such a special place. So to Katie and her family, to Jackie, to all of those affected by this accident, know that you're in our prayers for a swift recovery. And Katie, we look forward to seeing you back on the campaign trail real soon. God bless you. You know, it really is great to be back in South Carolina. So let me begin by bringing greetings from a friend of mine. And greetings from a great friend of Governor Henry McMaster, the man the people of South Carolina made the 45th President of the United States of America, President Donald Trump. You know, as the President reminded the nation, the people of South Carolina yesterday, early in his campaign, your governor was there, standing with candidate Donald Trump, and he made it possible for us to be in this place, to be serving the country in the way that we both are to this day. And I'm here today to say, President Trump and I, we stand with the people of South Carolina, and we stand with Governor Henry McMaster. Let me also say how impressed I am with this whole team. I'm kind of partial to running mates. So how about a big round of applause for your great nominee for Lieutenant Governor, a business leader that's been creating jobs all across South Carolina. Pamela Avett is going to be a great Lieutenant Governor. And to all the public servants who are with us today from across Myrtle Beach, North Myrtle Beach, members of the South Carolina General Assembly, and your great local Congressman, Tom Rice, thank you for your leadership. You know, I'm here because we stand with Governor McMaster, but I'm also here simply to say thank you. Thanks to the people of South Carolina, not only for your support on Election Day, but for your support every single day since. It's made it possible for us to be able to advance an agenda that's resulting in a stronger and more prosperous America. You know, you look at the last year and a half in this administration, I gotta tell you, there's only one way you can describe it. It's a little more than 500 days of action, 500 days of accomplishment. It's been a little more than 500 days of promises made and promises kept. I mean, think about it. Think about it. With the strong support of Governor Henry McMaster, the people of South Carolina, this president promised to rebuild our military and restore the arsenal of democracy. And it was just a few short months ago that President Trump signed the largest increase in our military spending since the days of Ronald Reagan. We are once again giving our soldiers, sailors, airmen, Marines, and Coast Guard the resources and training that they deserve and need to accomplish their mission and come home safe. Our president also promised, to stand with those who've worn the uniform. And with the strong support of the conservative leaders representing South Carolina in Washington, D.C., I'm pleased to say, President Trump has signed legislation that gives our veterans, finally, access to the kind of world-class health care that they earn in the uniform of the United States. And with the strong support of Henry McMaster and all of you, this president had promised back in those early days of the campaign that we'd be appointing strong conservatives to our courts at every level. And in the last year and a half, this president set a record for more federal court of appeals judges confirmed than any president in American history, and they're all conservatives like Justice Neil Gorsuch of the Supreme Court of the United States. With your support, President Trump promised to enforce our laws and secure our borders, and he's already obtained from the Congress more than $1.6 billion to start to build that wall. And we're going to end the crisis of illegal immigration with your support in our time. And finally, this president promised to get the economy of South Carolina moving again. Henry McMaster heard that message, and he knew it was the right message for the people of South Carolina. And he took a strong stand with the president during the course of the campaign. And since the outset of this administration, that's exactly what President Trump's been doing. This president's actually signed bills rolling back more federal red tape than any president in American history. President Trump put the American people first when we withdrew from the disastrous Paris Climate Accord, and we're developing American energy as never before. President Trump also said we're going to put American workers and American jobs first, and he's taken a strong stand to have trade deals that put a growing American economy as number one. And finally, Henry McMaster was there when this president promised early on that if he was elected, that we'd cut taxes across the board for working families, small businesses, and family farmers. And right before Christmas, in case you didn't notice it, President Trump signed the largest tax cuts and tax reform in American history. We cut taxes for working families. We cut taxes for businesses large and small. In fact, we cut out the heart of Obamacare. The individual mandate is gone. And the result of the policies that Governor McMaster's been there supporting every step of the way have been nothing short of remarkable. Since Election Day, 3.4 million new jobs have been created by businesses large and small. Unemployment hasn't been this low in 50 years. And we've seen the lowest number of unemployment numbers ever recorded for African Americans and Hispanic Americans. The American dream is coming back for every American. The truth is, under President Trump's leadership, with the strong support of your governor, we're turning America around. And I'm here today, and my friend's going to be here Monday. Because Governor Henry McMaster has been there supporting this administration every day. He's been there shoulder to shoulder with this president. And really, but it's nothing really new. Because Henry McMaster's been putting the people of South Carolina first his whole life. He was a U.S. attorney for South Carolina under President Ronald Reagan. In that capacity, he took on drug smugglers who were bringing those poisons into our communities and ripping families apart. He helped lead the Republican Party of South Carolina with great distinction and conservative principle. As Attorney General, he worked tirelessly to make South Carolina safe for families and children and communities. And for the past 2 years, Governor Henry McMaster has served in the highest office in this state, and he's leading a growing South Carolina. And the truth is, he had some pretty big shoes to fill. I don't know about the rest of you, but President Trump and I couldn't be more proud of Ambassador Nikki Haley and the job she's doing for America at the United Nations. But despite those big shoes, I got to tell you, as the president said just the other day, Governor McMaster's just done a great job. I mean, 20,000 new jobs have been created in just the last 2 years. More than $6 billion of new investment in workers and job creation all across South Carolina. In a word, men and women, Governor Henry McMaster means business, and he's just getting started. So he stood for jobs, he stood for security, but let me also say how grateful we are that he stood for the values that make South Carolina such a special place. Governor Henry McMaster has stood without apology for the sanctity of human life, and he's taken decisive action to ensure that no taxpayer dollars in the Palmetto State go to doctors who are even affiliated with abortion providers. He's taken a stand for life. As President Trump has said, Governor Henry McMaster stood with us, so now we need you to stand with him. This runoff election's coming around on Tuesday, and he deserves your support. I mean, the truth of the matter is, we got a couple things I gotta ask you to do before Karen and I take a chance to meet as many of you as we can, and then slip away back out of town. First and foremost, with the runoff election on Tuesday, number one, my first request, vote South Carolina and vote for Governor Henry McMaster. I mean, right? Okay, I mean, the truth is, in fact, you don't even have to wait till Tuesday. I did a little bit of homework here. You got this thing in South Carolina called in-person absentee voting. Starts on Monday, okay? I checked. If you live in Horry County, Board of Voter Registration and Elections office is just about 4 miles from here, 1515 4th Avenue, Conway, South Carolina, and it opens at 7 a.m. Get out and vote, South Carolina. Get it out of the way. And remember, friends don't let friends vote alone. Bring a friend. Bring a family member. Vote for Governor Henry McMaster. I'm telling you, it matters. Do it early. Because on Election Day, we need you out there. We need you to find a polling place where you can stop and tell a friend just how important this election is. And just how this good man is worthy of four more years to lead this great state. So that's number two. It's a part of that. Once you make plans to vote with a friend, right? And secondly, what I want you to do is go tell somebody. I mean, leave here today and go find somebody. Say, you know, I ran into Mike. And he was talking about all the things that President Trump has been able to do to turn this country around. And he told me that Governor Henry McMaster has been there every step of the way. And we got to make sure Governor Henry McMaster stays in office and keeps supporting an agenda that's making South Carolina and America strong again. I mean, reach out to people. I mean, over this weekend, go find them at the beach, right? Or at your place of worship tomorrow. Or on Monday morning, you know, reach out to people at work. Send out an email. I mean, just reach out and tell friends. You know, I always believe that all the TV commercials in the world, all the talking heads on TV, it don't matter a hill of beans compared to when somebody who knows you and puts great stock in your opinion hears from you about what's important. So in between now and when the polls close on Tuesday, I just want you to reach out and tell somebody who knows you and trusts you, we need four more years of Governor Henry McMaster for South Carolina and America. And lastly, if you're taking notes, after you vote, bring a friend. After you go tell everybody that you know between now and when the polls close on Tuesday, if you're of a mind, I'd encourage you maybe to do one more thing. In these two divided times across this country, you know, I'd encourage you to bow the head and bend the knee and remember to pray. And on this one, I know Henry won't mind. I'm not exactly asking you to pray for a candidate or pray for an outcome of an election. I just think prayer matters. And so I encourage you to just pray for South Carolina, pray for America, pray for this one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all, because prayer makes a difference. So if you do all of that, I got to tell you, it's been great being with you today. I mean, I'm incredibly humbled to have an opportunity to serve as vice president with this great president and to serve with him on behalf of all of you in South Carolina, and we're humbled by your support. But I leave here today encouraged, more encouraged than ever, that with your continued support, with your efforts reelecting this good man as governor of South Carolina, with Governor Henry McMaster in the State House, with all your great representation in Washington, D.C., and with President Donald Trump in the Oval Office, and with God's help, we will make South Carolina and America safe again. We will make South Carolina and America prosperous again. And to borrow a phrase, we will make America great again. Thank you very much, everybody. Now let's go to work and let's do four.